Welcome back to a second example of determining the function rule for a piecewise defined function given the graph. The first thing we should recognize from our graph is that we have three pieces, so we'll have to have three function rules for our piecewise defined function. Working from left to right, we'll have a function rule for this piece. That'll be our first function rule. We'll have a function rule for this piece, our second function rule. And then on the right, we have this piece here, which will also have its own function rule. And then for each piece, we'll have to define the domain or the interval for x. This one's a little more challenging than the previous example because we'll have to determine the equation of the line containing the blue segment and the equation of the line containing the yellow segment, which we'll find by using slope-intercept form of a line or the form f of x equals mx plus b, where m is the slope and b is the y-intercept. So if we focus on this blue segment, using the two endpoints, we should be able to determine the slope. Moving from left to right, from this point, notice how we'd have to move down 2 units, so the change in y is -2, and then right 2 units, meaning the change of x is +2, which means the slope, or m, is going to be equal to -2 divided by +2, or -1. Now we want to determine the y-intercept of the line that would contain this segment. Well, if we were to extend this segment, we should be able to see that the line would intersect the y-axis at +1, which means our y-intercept, or b, is +1. Also, knowing the slope is -1, which we can write as -1/1, from this point we could go down 1, right 1, and then again down 1, right 1, to determine our y-intercept is +1. So if m is -1 and b is +1, our function rule would be f of x equals -1 times x, or -x, plus 1. This is our first function rule. But we only want this line on the interval from -4 to -2, and because both endpoints are closed points, we want to include the endpoints, which means x is greater than or equal to -4 and less than or equal to -2. This would be the function rule and the interval for this first piece. Next, the green piece is a horizontal line or a constant function, so that function rule will be in the form of f of x equals a constant. In this case, we'll have f of x equals +1 or y equals +1. So that's our function rule. And then for the interval, it'll be from -2 to +1. Because of the open point, it will not include -2, but because of the closed point here, it will include +1. So x is greater than -2 and less than or equal to +1. And now for the last piece of the yellow piece, again, we'll have to find the equation of the line that would contain this segment. So again, we'll have to determine the slope and the y-intercept of the line containing this point. To determine the slope of this line, we should be able to use any two convenient points on this segment. So for example, if we use this point here, and let's say this point here, again, working from left to right, notice how we'd have a vertical change, or a change in y of +2, and a horizontal change of +1 because we're moving right. So the slope of this segment, or the line containing this segment, would be +2. So the slope is equal to +2. Now let's see if we can determine the y-intercept of this line. Well, if we extend this segment, notice how it would intersect the y-axis at +1, therefore the y-intercept is +1. Another way to determine this y-intercept, also notice from +1 on the y-axis, if we go up 2 and write 1, we would still be on the line containing this segment. So the function rule would be f of x equals 2x plus 1, and the interval would be from +1 to +4. Because of the open point, it does not include +1, but because of the closed point, it does include +4. So we would say x is greater than +1 and less than or equal to +4. Now notice for the blue piece and the yellow piece, we were graphically able to determine the equations of the lines that would contain these segments. but sometimes we may not be able to do that. So I want to show a second way to determine the function rules for the blue piece and the yellow piece. And this will involve using the endpoints of the segments, which would be two points on the line containing the two segments. So for this blue segment, if we wanted to, we could use the endpoints to determine the slope of the line using our slope formula here. So for the blue piece, using our slope formula, we would have m equals, for y2 minus y1, we'd have 3 minus 5. And then for x2 minus x1, we'd have negative 2 minus negative 4. Well, that would be negative 2 over, this would be negative 2 plus 4, or positive 2, which equals negative 1. And then we can use the point slope form of a line to determine our equation. So we'd have y, let's go ahead and use this point here. So we'd have y minus 5 equals negative 1 times x minus negative 4, or plus 4. Clear the parentheses and solve for y. We'd have y minus 5 equals negative 1x minus 4. Add 5 to both sides. We would have y equals, of course this is negative x, plus 1. Notice how if we go back to the previous slide, this is the same function rule we have here for the blue piece. Let's go ahead and do the same for the yellow piece. Again, we'll use the endpoints, which would be two points on the line containing this segment. So to find the slope, for y2 minus y1, we'd have 9 minus 3, all over x2 minus x1 would be 4 minus 1. So we'd have 6 divided by 3, which is equal to 2. And then using point slope form of a line, let's go ahead and use this first point. We'd have y minus 3 equals 2 times x minus 1. Clear the parentheses and then add 3 to both sides. Add 3 to both sides. We have y equals 2x plus 1, which again, if we go back to the previous slide, was the same function rule we found graphically. Okay, that's going to do it for this example. I hope you found this helpful.